Be our and watch us where we go. And help us to be wise in times when we don't know.
Let this be our To the Lord. For to this end, Christ died and lived again, that he might be Lord both of the dead and of the living. We brought nothing into this world, and we take nothing out. The Lord gives, and the Lord takes away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. The eternal God is our refuge, and underneath are the everlasting arms. Again, welcome to our celebration and thanksgiving for the life of Theresa Margaret Khadaran. Our service continues with the opening sentence, opening hymn, Blessed Assurance, as given on your bulletin, Blessed Assurance.
Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine. Heir of salvation, purchase of God, born of his Spirit, washed in his blood. This is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. Perfect submission, perfect delight, visions of rapture, troubles on my side. Angels descending, bring from above, echoes of vision, all is at rest. I in my Savior am happy and blessed. Watching and waiting, looking above, filled with His burning, lost in His love. This is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my song, this is my Savior, for the Lord. This is my song, this is my song, praising my
Please sit for the eulogy.
Need my glasses. Good afternoon, everyone. It's lovely to see so many friends and family gathered here today, both in person and online, to celebrate Theresa's life. Your presence today is a testament to life truly well lived. I am Jade Billowin-Batiste, Theresa's niece, and I'm reading this eulogy on behalf of my sister. Can you hear me better? Yeah, so I'm Jade Billowin-Batiste, Theresa's niece, and I am reading this eulogy on behalf of my sister, Cher, or Siobhan, as many of you know her, who could not be here in person today. Theresa was present in every phase of our lives. Every memory from our childhood that we hold dear includes her. She was more than an aunt to my sisters and myself. She supported us through many of life's moments, big and small, from driving us to and from school and helping us with our homework. I remember her consistently helping me with my art homework in secondary school because I was terrible at it. But she wanted to ensure I succeeded. She supported me when I left Trinidad to move to the US for college, and she came to visit me many times in the US. In addition to my mother, Theresa was always the other constant maternal figure in my life. The only thing that she did not teach me to do was to cook, because everyone knows that was not her specialty. There's a saying that states, blood is thicker than water. But Theresa showed us all that statement is not always true. She meant so much to so many people. Her family extended beyond blood relations. Not only was she Christopher's, Siobhan's, Shannon's, and my aunt, and great aunt to Harper by blood relation, but she was a second mother to Arlene, Dion, Karen, Francois, and Jonathan. Second grandmother to Deshaun, Jaden, Kaya, Callie, and Zaya. And of course, cousin to David and Anne. She and Anne spoke for hours every single day. Only the two of them knew what there was to talk about so many times. We love you, Anne. And let's not forget her Clico family, who have become our family. Neil Jones, her ex-boss, and Clico were her life. There were so many Clico people at our family functions that you would swear it was a MDRT convention each time. Only Clico people might get that joke. Her neighbors from Seabreeze Apartments, both past and present, have too also become our family. She was Seabreeze's longest resident, almost 40 years, and thoroughly enjoyed the excitement, aka Bacchanal, that seemed to be always happening there. She held on to and treasured so many important friendships, including all the way back to those who she attended St. James Secondary School with, and was proud of the fact that she was part of the first class of students at that school. She loved you all. Her friends became our friends and extended family. She was and forever will be the tie that binds us all. Theresa's legacy shows us all not to only keep our family members close, but to also value and cherish our friendships so that they can be lifelong, and to open our homes and hearts to our community. Everyone knows that if you saw Teresa, you also saw my mother, Gloria. They were like two peas in a pod. Their sisterhood and love for each other was inspiring, and I will continue to try to mirror that relationship with my two sisters. When our mother passed, a part of Teresa went with her. But now I take comfort in knowing that they are back together again. If there's anything like a Pennywise or Price Smart on the other side, I'm sure that both of them are likely there right now just knocking about. We want to sincerely thank each of you for being part of Teresa's and our lives and for supporting our family. We want to thank everyone who helped care for Teresa over the past few months, and to thank all those who visited and reached out to Teresa and us. Every one of these precious encounters sustained her and our family. Your outpouring of love and support has held us together in this difficult time. Although we feel sadness at this great loss, we are here to celebrate all 74 years of Teresa's wonderful life. She was strong, independent, feisty, stubborn at times, but always there when we needed her. In the days to come, we can all take solace by letting our minds wander to any one of the many cherished memories we had with Teresa, and smile knowing that we were blessed by having her in our lives. There's a quote that says, "The highest tribute to the dead is not grief, but gratitude." So thank you, Teresa, for always being an endless source of love and support in our lives. We will hold you in our hearts forever. Rest in peace. Thank you.
Is there any else? Is there any other short tribute? Okay, so let us stand. Your response will be, "Holy God, holy and mighty, holy mortal one, have mercy upon us." Response, "Holy God, holy and mighty, holy mortal one, have mercy upon us. In the midst of life we are in death. From whom can we seek help? From you alone, O Lord, who by our sins are justly angered." Response, "Holy God, holy and mighty, holy immortal one, have mercy upon us. Lord, you know the secrets of our hearts. Shut not your ears to our prayers, but spare us, O Lord." Response, "Holy God, holy and mighty, holy immortal one, have mercy upon us. O worthy and eternal judge, do not let the pains of death turn us away from you at our last hour." Response, "Holy God, holy and mighty, holy immortal one, have mercy upon us." Let us pray. Almighty God, we remember before you today your servant Teresa, and we pray that having opened to her the gates of larger life, you receive her more and more into your joyful service, that with all who have served you in the past, she may share in the eternal victory of Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Please sit for the ministry of the word. Now have our reading from first from Isaiah 61 verses 1 to 3.
G'day, I'm Jaden, and I'll be doing the reading today. A reading from the book of Isaiah 61, verse 1 to 3. "The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, because the Lord has anointed me. He has sent me to bring good news to the oppressed, to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives, and to release the prisoners. To proclaim the year of the Lord's favor and the day of vengeance of our God. To comfort all who mourn, to provide for those who mourn in Zion, to give them a garland instead of ashes, the oil of gladness instead of mourning, the mantle of praise instead of a faint spirit. They will be called the oaks of righteousness, the planting of the Lord to display his glory. The word of the Lord.
Remain seated and sing the 23rd Psalm. The Lord is my shepherd. I'll give them our bulletin. Please stand for the gospel. The Lord be with you. Reading from the Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John. Glory to Christ, our Savior. John chapter 11, verses 21 to 27. Martha said to Jesus, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. But even though I know that God will give you whatever you ask of him, Jesus said to her, your brother will rise again. Martha said to him, I know that he will rise again in the resurrection on the last day. Jesus said to her, I am the resurrection and the life. Those who believe in me, even though they die, will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this? Martha said to Jesus, yes, Lord, I believe that you are the Messiah, the Son of God, the one coming into the world. The Gospel of Christ. Praise to Christ, our Lord. I bring you this short message in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please be seated. This is already a rather exceptional funeral, because particularly in these times of COVID, we have been having very many funerals, as you can probably imagine. But I must say, this is one funeral where the average age of the congregation is very low. As I look around, I see so many young people at this particular funeral. It's rather exceptional. We are quite accustomed having funerals with the average age probably closer to my own, about 73, right? Just around the age of Theresa. But this is a really young congregation. There must be something different about Theresa, why she was able to attract so many young persons here with us today. I hardly see any old persons. I'm not quite sure why, but it's rather exceptional, I must say, to see so many young persons here at this funeral. I say there must be something exceptional about Theresa. Now, this morning at our morning prayer, because as you know, the church has several kinds of services, what we call, referred to as the liturgy of the church. We have several forms of worship. And of course, the most popular services are those held on Sunday, the Lord's Day, particularly Holy Communion in this church, the Anglican Church, in the Roman Catholic Church, in the Episcopal Church, as well as in the Orthodox Church, which is the second largest church in the world, Russian Orthodox Church, Greek Orthodox Church, and so on. The most popular services are the Mass, Holy Communion, Holy Eucharist. It has all these different names. But also, during the week, every day we have what is called a daily office. We say morning prayer and evening prayer. Not quite as popular, but many persons still follow what they call the daily office, saying morning prayer and evening prayer. So this morning at morning prayer, there was the reading from the Gospel of Mark. So, well, actually, the reading was from the Gospel of John, but the same thing is in the Gospel of Mark, about the Jesus feeding the 5,000. Jesus feeding the 5,000. And I'm sure you must have heard about that miracle of Jesus, right, where they had this young boy with 5 loaves and 2 fish, and Jesus broke the loaves and was able to feed a crowd of 5,000 people, right, and have enough bread left back to fill 12 baskets. How many have heard about that particular miracle of Jesus? You can raise your hand if you have heard about that. Oh yes, right, so most persons have heard about that miracle, right? About the second most popular miracle of Jesus. And you probably know what is the most popular miracle of Jesus. What is that one? The most popular one is turning water into wine. I think everybody heard about that one, right? Jesus turning water into wine. Okay? Right, right. We're getting some nods, right? That most people have heard about that particular miracle. So Jesus was this miracle worker. Right? Going around Palestine in those days and doing many miracles, and many miracles which made him, made the people recognize that he was God. He was the Son of God. In fact, we say we have a special feast of the year. This comes right after Christmas, called Epiphany, Feast of the Epiphany. And that is the time when we speak about Jesus manifesting himself as God, as the Son of God. Why am I saying all of this? This is because the gospel reading that I just read, the gospel passage that I just read, recounts one of, is a prelude to one of Jesus' greatest miracles. And that was when Jesus raised Lazarus from the dead. It was not as popular a miracle as turning water into wine or feeding the 5,000, but certainly his most spectacular miracle. And that is what this is, the prelude, the passage I read is the prelude to that particular miracle. Because Lazarus was a friend of Jesus, and he had two sisters, Martha and Mary. Probably you might have heard the story, right? And two sisters, Martha and Mary. And Lazarus got sick. But Jesus didn't go immediately to their home in Bethany, which was just outside of Jerusalem. He took some time before getting to their home. And by the time he arrived there, Lazarus had already died. And that is where the passage starts off. Because Martha met him, and Martha said to Jesus, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died." Right? And that is how the story starts. In fact, both sisters, Martha and Mary, tell Jesus the same thing. "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died." And Jesus then asks them, right? You know, "Why are you so worried about the death of your brother? Do you not know that he would rise again?" I'm trying to cut this story short in the interest of time. Right? "Do you not believe that he would rise again?" So that Jesus first told them, "Yes, your brother has died, but death is not the end. He was going to rise again." And Martha said to him, "Yes, I know he'll rise again at the resurrection." But then Jesus said to her, "I am the resurrection and the life. Those who believe in me, even though they die, will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die." So that is an important conversation between Jesus and Martha. Because Martha was concerned that her brother had died, and that Jesus, if he were there, would have been able to prevent him from dying. But Jesus is saying, "No, well, your brother is going to rise again at the resurrection." Right? "And I am the resurrection and the life. Those who believe in me, even though they die physically at one point in time, they will live to eternal life. They will never die." And that is the important message that we always say at funerals, that death is, as it were, the pathway to eternal life. That when somebody dies here on earth, if they believed in Jesus and lived a life pleasing to Jesus, even though they have died, they will live. They will live if they have lived a life pleasing to Jesus. And then they will be ushered into eternal life. And those are the sentiments that her niece just expressed, that her mother would have gone ahead of Theresa. But if both of them live lives pleasing to God, that both of them will see one another again. because both of them will rise at the resurrection to eternal life. But that is the hope, which is the hope that Hadith just expressed, that those who die have not died in vain. Death is not the end. Death is the pathway, or death ushers us into eternal life. And that has to be the hope, that death is not the end, that death is the pathway to eternal life. But Jesus was always very clear. This pathway to eternal life would be for those who believe in him. And elsewhere he says, those who believe in him and those who live lives pleasing to God. In other words, those persons who live lives where those lives can see the light of judgment. In other words, if persons live lives that are not pleasing to God, right, then they cannot be assured of eternal life. Jesus said at other times that the way to eternal life is to do things pleasing to God. Feed the poor, see about those who are ill, visit the persons in prison, clothe people who are naked, and so on. Jesus gave many kinds of examples of the way we ought to live our lives if we want to see at the judgment we be among those persons who are chosen for eternal life. And just to finish the story of Lazarus, as you probably know also, the story didn't end where this passage ends, because Jesus was so moved to compassion because of the hurt, because of the deep pain that Mary and Martha were suffering, that Jesus actually raised Lazarus from the dead. So soon after this passage, if you read the Gospel of John, Jesus actually raised Lazarus from the dead. And Lazarus was able to come out of the tomb that he was in and start again life here on earth, which, as I said, was one of Jesus' greatest miracles. So much so that the Jewish authorities got very vexed with Jesus, because people were coming from all over the Palestine to see this Lazarus whom Jesus had raised from the dead. So that turned out to be one of Jesus' greatest miracles, and also the miracle that gave him a lot of trouble with the Jewish authorities. So after that, Jesus became so popular that the scribes and the Pharisees and so on, the leaders of the Jews, plotted his death. So the message at funerals is always that we should prepare ourselves for our own death. Now, as I said, with so many young people here, particularly young people don't really think very much about death. And that's right. I mean, there's no reason why a young person should feel that they should be dying soon. But even at a young age, we could still start thinking about, you know, what is going to happen in the end. And Jesus would like persons to believe in him, not only when they're close to death, but from even when they are quite young. Even when you are quite young, you can come to Jesus. You can believe in Jesus and live your life, or start living your life in a manner that is pleasing to Jesus. So we pray that this funeral will be a time for us to reflect on our own lives. And we also pray that Teresa's life, as we just heard from the eulogy, was one of blessing for persons, compassion, sympathy, caring for persons, and that she lived a life pleasing to God, so that at the judgment, she will be among those who will be selected for eternal life, along, of course, with Gloria and her other siblings, and that they will all see one another again. And we pray that we all will live our lives pleasing to God, and that we all will eventually inherit everlasting life. The Lord be with you. We have a car, PDK 4977, blocking the driveway. Pump. Could you please move your car? Thank you. So let us stand. And let us with confidence and hope confess the faith into which we were baptized as we say the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Your response will be, Lord, graciously hear us. Response, Lord, graciously hear us. For our sister Theresa, let us pray to the Lord Christ who said, I am the resurrection and I am the life. Lord, you console Martha and Mary in their distress. Draw near to us who mourn for Theresa and dry the tears of those who weep. Lord, hear us. You wept at the grave of Lazarus, your friend. Comfort us in our sorrow. Lord, hear us. You raise the dead to life. Raise our sister Teresa to eternal life. Lord, hear us. You promise paradise to the thief who repented. Bring our sister Teresa to the joys of heaven. Lord, hear us. Our sister was washed in baptism and anointed with the Holy Spirit. Give her fellowship with all your saints. Lord, hear us. She was nourished with your body and blood. Grant her a place at the table in your heavenly kingdom. Lord, hear us. Comfort us in our sorrows at the death of our sister Teresa. Let our faith be our consolation and eternal life our hope. Again, we want to extend our sympathy to members of the family. May God continue to bless Teresa. May her soul rest in peace. Lord Jesus Christ, we commend to you our sister Teresa, who was reborn by water and spirit in holy baptism. Grant that her death may recall to us your victory over death and be an occasion for us to renew our trust in your Father's love. Give us, we pray, the faith to follow where you have led the way and where you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit to the ages of ages. Amen. Please sit at this time and we will have our offertory or offering hymn. What a friend we have in Jesus. Offering him, what a friend we have in Jesus.
Thank you.
Please stand for the commendation. Give rest to Christ, to your servant, with your saints, where sorrow and pain are no more, neither sign, but life everlasting. You only are immortal, the creator and maker of mankind. And we are mortal, formed of the earth, and to earth we shall return. For so did you ordain when you created me, saying, you are dust, and to dust you shall return. All of us go down to the dust, yet even at the grave we make our song. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Let us commend our sister Theresa to the mercy of God, our Maker and Redeemer. Deliver your servant, O sovereign Lord Christ, from all evil, and set her free from every bond, that she may rest with all your saints in the eternal habitations, where with the Father and the Holy Spirit you live and reign, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Into your hands, O Lord, O merciful Savior, we commend your servant Theresa. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive her into the arms of your mercy, in the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints in light. We now say the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, come to the committal. I heard a voice from heaven saying, write this, happy are the dead who die in the faith of Christ. Henceforth, says the Spirit, they may rest from their labors, for they take with them the record of their deeds. Man born of a woman has but a short time to live. Like a flower, he blossoms and then withers. Like a shadow, he flees and never stays. Lord God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal, holy and most merciful Savior, deliver us from the bitter pains of eternal death. You know the secrets of our hearts. In your mercy, hear our prayer. Forgive us our sins, and at our last hour, let us not fall away from you. Amen. In sure and certain hope of resurrection to eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ, we commend to Almighty God our sister Theresa, and we commit her body to the ground. Earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. And we beseech you in your infinite goodness to give us grace to live in your dear love and to die in your favor, that when your well-beloved Son shall come again in judgment, both this, our sister Theresa, and we ourselves may be found acceptable in your sight. Grant this for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Grant, O Lord, to all who are bereaved the spirit of faith and courage, that they will have the strength to meet the days to come with steadfastness and patience, not sorrowing as those without hope, but in thankful remembrance of your great goodness, and in a joyful expectation of eternal life with those they love. And this we ask in the name of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Merciful Father and Lord of all life, we praise you that most people are made in your image. Or we praise you that people are made in your image and reflect your truth and light. We thank you for the life of your daughter Theresa, for the love and mercy she received from you and showed among us. Above all, we rejoice at your gracious promise to all your servants, living and departed, that we shall rise again at the coming of Christ. And we ask that in due time, we may share with our sister Theresa that clearer vision, when we shall see your face, we shall see each other in the same Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Rest eternal, granted Theresa, O Lord, and let light perpetual shine upon her. May she and all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace. Amen. The Lord bless her and keep her. The Lord make his face to shine upon her and be gracious to her. The Lord lift up his countenance upon her and give her peace. Alleluia, Christ is risen. The Lord is risen indeed. Alleluia. Let us go forth in the name of Christ. Thanks be to God. Our service has ended. We now have our recessional hymn. I'm walking on the way to the Lord. I'm walking the way to the Lord. I've also given in our bulletin.
When we lose all Spirit.